Hey everybody, thank you for clicking on today's video. If you are new to my channel, my name is Casey and I post videos every single Wednesday on the lesser known missing person cases that haven't received a whole lot of media attention. I mean absolutely no harm in doing these videos, I am simply trying to spread awareness, and if you would like to support me, I would appreciate it so much. All you have to do is give this video a like and hit that subscribe button. Today's case is on Wesley Dale Morgan. Wesley was 2 years old and he was living with his 19-year-old mother, Ruby Havard, and her boyfriend, Burnell Hilton, in a home Burnell rented on Highway 63 near Bluff Creek in Clinton, Louisiana. Ruby shared custody of Wesley with Wesley's father, Dewey Morgan, who also lived in Clinton but at a different residence. On Tuesday, May 15, 2001, a little before 10 o'clock in the morning, Wesley was on his front porch playing with some puppies, and his mother left him there unattended to go inside the house and fix something to eat. She was only in the house for a few minutes, but when she came back outside to check on Wesley, he was no longer where she had left him. She did not call 911. Instead, she called the jail, which doesn't make a lot of sense to me, but I guess if you're in a panic and that's a number that you just remember for some reason, that would be the first number you call. I'm not sure, but she did call the police. The community hurried to help. Volunteers from all over the parish, as well as police, searched a 2-mile radius around the home and nearby bodies of water such as ponds and creeks. People were on horses and four-wheelers to aid in the search for Wesley, as well as on foot. They even drained one of the ponds close to the property, fearing that he may have fallen in and drowned, but they found nothing.
The National Guard even brought their helicopters in with thermal imaging. The thermal imaging devices can detect heat even if someone is hiding under brush or trees, and it can do so during the day or at night. So if Wesley was in the woods alive, they likely would have found him.
Sniffer dogs were brought in, but they could not pick up on Wesley's trail. At the time of his disappearance, Wesley was 3 feet tall and weighed 40 pounds. He has blonde hair and blue eyes. He was last seen wearing a gray Mickey Mouse t-shirt, blue shorts with a green stripe extending down one side, and he had sandals on his feet. During the search, it was found that two of the puppies that Wesley had been playing with had also disappeared, and one was actually found. It was found a little ways away across the highway from the home. I'm not exactly sure how far away the puppy was, but they thought it was farther than Wesley could have possibly traveled on his own. Burnell's truck was also examined inside and out, and they were looking for any sign of blood or any kind of evidence that a crime had been committed or there had been a body in there, but they didn't find anything. At first they thought that Wesley had simply wandered off, but when they couldn't find anything and the sniffer dogs couldn't even pick up on his scent, they began to think that maybe someone had taken him. Maybe this was a kidnapping and not just a child getting lost. But the home is kind of down a little hill, and it's far back from the main road and kind of has a long driveway. It would be really hard for someone to drive down there, grab a child and two puppies, stick them in the car, turn around and get out of there quietly. I believe the driveway's gravel also. I could be wrong, but I believe in the pictures it looked like it was gravel. And gravel's noisy when you drive over it, so if you were going to do that, you would have to be driving really, really slow. So if someone did drive down there, they weren't in a rush and weren't, it would seem they weren't really worried about getting caught. I don't know. Ruby stated that she hadn't heard anything unusual while she was inside the house. She hadn't heard a car pull in or any kind of commotion outside. Almost immediately, suspicion was placed on his mother, Ruby, and her boyfriend, Burnell. They did agree to the home and the property being searched, but I think maybe the way Ruby was acting caused people to be questioning her involvement. She wasn't as frantic about her child being missing as people thought she should be. She wasn't asking questions about what had been found or how the search was going, and I guess she just kind of seemed disinterested in the whole thing. Most parents would be calling nonstop and trying to find out what was going on, but she didn't. Rumors were also being spread that she had sold Wesley or given him away to someone, which does happen. People do it all the time. Ruby and Burnell were given polygraph tests, which they both failed, showing signs of deception. Burnell Hilton had been charged with murder that same year that Wesley disappeared in an unrelated shooting that happened in 1998. I don't know the details of that case, but I thought it was something that was worth noting. Ruby and Burnell both deny having any involvement in Wesley's disappearance. The couple soon split up after Wesley's disappearance and Ruby began dating someone else. This man was also questioned and his property was searched, but nothing was found. I believe he was investigated because someone had reported seeing a child resembling Wesley near his property, but that lead didn't pan out to be of any significance. A few months after Wesley vanished, they received a lead that his remains had been buried in a spot in St. Helena Parish. They did find remains there, but it ended up being the remains of a dog. A psychic also came to law enforcement saying that Wesley was buried in the property of the home on Bluff Creek where he was last seen.
Since they hadn't received any other tips in quite some time, authorities did do another search, but did not locate a grave or any evidence that a body had been buried there.
6 years after Wesley's disappearance, Ruby was arrested for trying to sell her new baby boy. He was only a couple of weeks old at the time, I believe. She allegedly tried to sell him to a couple from California for $2,000. She pled not guilty and said that it was supposed to be an adoption, but something went wrong. I do not believe an adoption agency was involved in that, though. According to AmericanAdoptions.com, there are no adoption agencies that are going to pay you money to give your child up for adoption. It is illegal to accept money for your baby. If you do this, it's not adoption, it's trafficking. You can, however, receive financial assistance for expenses related to the pregnancy. Food, rent assistance, transportation to doctor visits, help with your utilities, things like that. I believe they'll even help you get a cell phone, but they are not going to hand you a wad of cash for your baby. The charges were later dismissed. That baby boy was put into state custody and she was let out of jail after paying the fee for the paperwork, which was only $30. In 2015, another search by the FBI was done in the woods and surrounding property of the home, but again, nothing was found. 21 billboards were put up in Louisiana and Mississippi with Age Progress photos of Wesley in hopes that someone would recognize him and call in with information. They were really trying to get the case out there again. Both sides of Wesley's family have been cooperative with law enforcement. They don't believe Dewey, Wesley's father, was involved in any way, but many people, including investigators, believe that his mother, Ruby, knows exactly what happened to him. It is believed that he was either given to someone or was sold in an illegal adoption for $2,000. I'm not sure where they got that amount. I couldn't find much information on that except for she had allegedly told people that that was the amount of money. I'm not sure why she wasn't charged with anything in Wesley's case. You would think she would have been charged with neglect or even child endangerment, something, but she wasn't. Personally, I wouldn't think a 2-year-old could make it very far on their own in that short span of time. I know little ones can get away from you very fast, but it seems like someone would have heard him crying or found him during the extensive search that they did. He may have wandered off on his own and gotten hurt or killed, but even then, they would have found his body. Or he could have been abducted. I mean, maybe someone was sneaky enough to pull it off. Maybe someone in the home hurt him intentionally or even by accident and then hid his body. Maybe his mother did give him away to someone else. Wesley may be out there and not even know that he's a missing child. He was so young when he went missing. He may have been raised by an entirely different family and he may not know that they're not his biological relatives or that people are even looking for him. Wesley would be 21 years old now and, you know, he's a man and he may have a family of his own and not have a clue that people are still posting flyers and making videos and searching and wanting to know what happened to him. Law enforcement doesn't believe that it was a kidnapping or that he wandered off on his own. But no one has been charged with anything concerning Wesley's case because they don't have enough evidence. They do believe he is alive. What do you think happened to Wesley? Leave your theories in the comments. I would love to hear your take on this. His family would absolutely love to find him, and they hope that someday they can be reunited and have some kind of relationship with him. He has a whole family that he doesn't even know he has. If you have any information on Wesley's location or information on his disappearance, please contact the East Feliciana Parish Sheriff's Office at 225-683-5459, the FBI at 1-800-225-5324, or Crime Stoppers at 504-822-1111. Please help keep Wesley's case out there by sharing his flyer, sharing this video, and sharing his story. It is still an open investigation, and there is a $10,000 reward through the FBI for any information on Wesley's whereabouts. Thank you all so much for watching my video. Please don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I will see you next time. Bye.